The first thing we need to do is recognize that x sec squared of x is a product of two functions of x. Therefore, we can use integration by parts, which is given by the formula integral of u dv equals to uv take away integral of v du. Now, the next step is to choose u and dv from the question. We will choose u equals to x as it differentiates down to a constant, which is very, very important as we shall see later on, and dv equals to sec squared of x dx as it integrates easily. So we want to compute v and du. For du, we differentiate u equals to x and we get du equals to dx. And we integrate dv equals to sec squared x dx. And we know that the integral of sec squared is tan, so v equals to tan x. So now we've got all the components here and we can substitute them into the formula. So we end up with integral of x sec squared x dx equals to x tan x minus integral of tan x dx. Now we will use the very useful log trick to integrate tan of x. Notice that we can write integral of tan of x dx as integral of sine x over cos x dx. And since the derivative of cos x is minus sine x, this can be written in the form minus integral of f prime of x over f of x dx, which we know is equal to natural log of modulus of f of x plus c. So we get integral of tan of x dx equal to minus natural log of modulus of cos x. And that is, of course, equal to natural log of modulus of sec x. Therefore, plugging it all in, we get x tan x minus natural log of modulus of sec x plus c, which is the answer.